Welcome to topic three. In this topic, we're going to do a thought experiment. So what I'd like you to do is to close your eyes and just listen to my voice. Now, don't be scared. I'm not going to hypnotize you. I'm not going to take you on some freaked out new age hippie journey. Just relax, close your eyes, take a few deep breaths and listen to my voice. Okay. Now, for the first part, I want you to concentrate on your body. So just feel your body. Don't move your hand around your body, but feel your body from the inside. Be aware of your limbs, all of your toes and your fingers, your arms and your legs. Be aware of your own breathing, the falling and rising of your chest. Now listen to my voice. As I speak, I'm causing changes in the air pressure in the room. And these changes in air pressure are causing your eardrums to vibrate. That movement is being transmitted to a receptor within your ear, and it's sending an electrical signal to the brain, that part of the brain involved in the perception of sound. Now, scrunch up your eyes tightly. Those dancing lights that you see are caused by stimulation of receptor cells in the back of your eye. And normally they would be stimulated by light coming from objects around you. These receptor cells are sending electrical signals to the brain, this time to areas involved in the perception of light. Now what I want you to do is to pinch the finger and thumb of one hand together. That sensation of pressure is mediated by touch receptors in your skin. And once again, they're sending electrical signals up the length of your arm to specialized brain areas involved in the perception of touch. Okay, let's forget about the bodily sensations for a moment. Keep your eyes closed. I want you to imagine that you're walking along a beach and you can feel the sand between your toes. It's a beautiful warm day and you're feeling very comfortable as you walk along the sand. Up ahead, you see a rope extending up from the sand into the sky and disappearing up into nowhere. As you get closer to the rope, you see it's very thick and you grab onto the rope and you start climbing, and it's very easy, it's almost effortless, and you climb higher and higher and higher up the rope. Eventually you decide to let go and you float very easily down to the ground and feel your feet in the sand once again. Okay, what I'd like you to do now is to think about someone who has done something nice for you in the past. Do you have good feelings towards that person? Do you like them? Do you love them? Just hold on to that feeling for a moment. Now what I'd like you to do is to try and recall your oldest memory. What is it? Is it from your childhood? And can you remember who was with you at the time, or were you alone? And what are some feelings associated with that memory? Okay, open your eyes. Now, we often feel when we introspect like this, intro, inside, spect as in spectator, we often feel when we introspect like this that the mind and the body are two separate things. On the one hand, there is the body that does all the mundane tasks of sensing and feeling. And the other part is the thinking and feeling part. And it's pretty easy to imagine how the body might produce all these different sensations that we feel when we stimulate our senses. So there are neurons with well-defined properties and they generate electrical signals which are carried to the brain. And as a result, I see things and I hear people talking to me and I feel pressure on my skin. Mental experience, on the other hand, seems to fall into a completely different category of things. So when you were imagining walking along the beach and feeling the sand between your toes, where exactly was that occurring and how do we create that image inside our head? And when you walked up to the rope and started climbing up it, how is it possible that we can do that inside of our heads? I'm sure you've never encountered a rope just going up from the middle of the beach and then climbing up it. So how can we do things that are impossible inside our head? There's no mental screen that we throw images up onto. So how can we have those images inside of our head? And who's looking at those images in the first place? It's the same thing with feelings. When we were thinking about someone who's done something nice for us, where was that feeling actually occurring? Was it occurring in your heart, in your head? Where was it? So where is the mind located and what is its relationship to the body? This is our next question for topic 4.